I guess me and Anthony, we're heading down here to Chattanooga over to ADC. Do a little scouting today. We got a draw hunt coming up here soon. So hopefully we see some good deer sign today. And maybe here in a couple weeks we get us a couple of deer down.
Hey guys, this is that rub that we had found. It seems pretty fresh, hopefully. We got a big one on it. Now we're going to come over here to the edge of the field where the power lines. And there's a pretty good trail and a scrape. We'll just show you a little bit of what we look for when we come in to scout an area. Well, that's something new right there that we didn't see earlier. That's a scrape and doe poop. It's over a licking branch. And we just keep following this down right on the edge. And here's another scrape with a branch. Right here we have a rub. It's on a little cedar tree. I don't know if you guys can see that well. And it just continues to keep going down. Stay tuned and we'll show you some more, okay?
So guys, here's a couple of the rubs that we've come across today. This one's a little bit smaller. Here's a scrape, guys. Nice little licking branch there. Got a lot of trails, guys, that are coming in and out of there. We might actually end up going to the other side here shortly and kind of checking out what it looks like as well.
could be a rub from last year.
Guys, if you're unsure about how to go about scouting, just get in the woods and see some places. Like, you want to see a lot of white oaks, look for acorns. You'll start noticing trails. Just anything that looks out of place on a trail. One may be coming down a bank and may just be this one raw patch of dirt. You may even see hoof prints. You just don't know until you get out there and just look. We try to base it off of some type of clearings. Where's the thickets? Is there any water nearby? You know, just easy access for deer, because deer is going to go around an object versus over an object. And so you just kind of think like how they would. Like, this looks like somebody had an old road bed right here. And that's possibly a travel corridor for the deer. I mean, it's easy. They just walk around stuff instead of over stuff. Look right there, that looks like an older rub. Well, guys, I guess I'm going to get off here and do a little bit more scouting. So, good luck, and stay tuned, and hopefully we get some.
What's going on, guys? Back with you here. Me and David are standing up in this power line edge and found a pretty tore up scrape here underneath this pond. Definitely think this is going to be our pick for now. That's where we're probably going to try to get in here and hunt at. Definitely liking the side we're seeing in here. So we're going to try to check it out a little more and see if we can't find spots for both of us. In here, with as much time as we're finding, I think we're going to be in good shape. Get back to you for it.
Hey guys. Alright, so as we explained, we're out here at ADC. And we've done some scouting since our first Titan Anthony talk today. We had found just a few scrapes and rubs. We kept just walking up a little bit here on the break where the power lines are, and ended up finding two really good scrapes. I mean, we'll show you in the footage, but they're pretty awesome. Look like they've fairly been used pretty good. So I believe what we're going to do is we're going to try to set up, find some tree in here, so that way whenever we come in during season, we can get us hopefully a nice big old buck. But I'd set up for a nice little tree there as well.
All right, guys. We just finished scouting out the first area here on AEDC. Found quite a bit of good sign. Started out a little rough. Wasn't looking too good. Like, this was going to be that good of a spot. Ran across one rub, and then that kind of led us into some more. I think we've got a pretty good spot here. Probably go check out another spot later. What's your thoughts, David?
Yeah, I guess this is probably going to be our main spot that we'll come here and hunt, but I believe what we're going to do is get a secondary spot for just in case this one is taken. This is public land to be able to hunt on, so I believe always having a second spot just in case is better, so that way we're not having to walk in the blind. Because you just never know if you're coming here scouting, you just never know what deer's going to be.
Yeah, it's always public land. That's always the joy. And with the way it works here in Tennessee, they have several wildlife management units that you can put in on a draw for, and they had the quota hunt. I think the particular hunt that David and myself got drawn for, I think it's a 900 quota hunt. So 900 other hunters, including us. So that's going to be quite a bit of people out here, you know, fighting for the good spots. The good thing is, you know, we're out here doing our homework. spending the day down here trying to find a couple of good spots. That way we're covered. So, and as well, you know, trying to get off the beaten path a little bit, not hunt, you know, right off the road, easy access. Where we're at, we do get a deer. We're gonna have our work cut out for us getting them out of here.
Yeah, it's gonna be a little rough. I think what the drag is several hundred yards and a bunch of thick stuff that we'll have to go through. But you know, I believe with time and patience, you know, we may get a big and that will pay off. So you end up having to drag on that.
All right, guys, we're gonna load back up here in the car and stay here and look at the map for a few minutes and decide what we're gonna do for Plan B.
All right, guys, have a good night.
Yeah.